This program is rated 16. Parental guidance is advised.
Welcome to the show. The show is called the Happy Life of Nonsense. Better on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. From 8 up to 8:30 p.m. How are you? Hi. Oh my God, I missed you. Did you miss me? You're supposed to say yes, but some people, some of you are not romantic. My name is Tumusiime. Follow me on social media. Thank you so much for following me. Tumusiime, that's on Facebook. Tumu then Siime. Then on Twitter at Tumusiime UG. Instagram at Tumusiime UG. Then you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. That is Tumu. YouTube channel is Tumusiime. I'd forgotten, man. Secondly, these banabakola ku mataraga bani man tevanjagara. Shigira. Kwanga wangamba. You're too black. Yangamba man. So as you can see right now, in life ningo mchotara. I want to people meet me in person, because a girl meet me in person like, oh my God, so you look like white man. I say, yes, man. So okay, that's actually neocolonialistic. Neocolonialism. Not supposed to say that to Ikanga Bazuko. So man, today we have funny stories. Now, this first story. Hey, man. Jesus, man. What's wrong with us as people, man? Mboni Yabawachi, you know, I know the word sheep is supposed to be like, I don't know, like a placeholder. It doesn't actually mean that you're a sheep. You know? What did Mbonye give to the remnants? So Oyomwana Gwemula Bamita Babirye. She's a prophet. Yeah, prophet Babirye. Of course they always have to take the surname of Mbonye. Mbonye something something Babirye. Shtegira. I have seen stupidity and nonsense. I have never seen anyone speak as much stupidity as that woman. So this woman called, is it Babirye something? Babirye, Juliet. This is called Juliet. Juliet? Ivlet. I don't know. One of those three names. Let's take it. Now she's a remnant. Katina B. Let's take it. She you're tapping on Wi-Fi. This witchcraft of his, he puts it on hotspots. So what took her now take a walk on and take a session and walk on prophesying a future. Of course, you cannot prophesy to him at his level because he's a chigara, he's the closer. So, like for him, he prophesies about the Oscars, prophesies about the Prime Minister of Britain. You're prophesying like about LC1 chairman, people who are going to get drug overdose. So, this girl was on national television. I'm going to try to recoup the story so that some of you didn't see it. It's because it's been everywhere on Twitter, on Facebook, and on YouTube. Apparently, Mbonye resurrected her from the dead. I say, what? Okay. First of all, when you say that, that's the reason why I watched the video. Because I have some body parts which need some resurrecting. I am sick and tired of reaching the endless part. And then some people are too dead. Man. Come on. I say, yeah, you start negotiating. You're like, man, dude, man, come on, man. Okay, now we move. Okay. 2 seconds now. So when I heard that this man actually can resurrect dead people, I thought, okay, I need to watch this. Maybe I can put in a prayer request and somebody part about Umuntu Awansi. I don't know resurrecting. I don't know what's happening to my. Am I stressed? Or am I overworking? So I start watching, they were not talking about that in Jagal, of course. We were talking about some other things. This girl, apparently, she was on a border, and the border took her to a peculiar stage where other border people were. But they knew the border guy that brought here. And this is the funny thing. Before she went there, Professor Mbonye had told her, Namugamba, it seems like you're going to run into problems, you woman. Then he continued. What sort of person is that, man? It's like someone saying, your woman is going to cheat on you tomorrow, but it's okay, man. You'll get some STDs. Like, if you go, how can you have a health prophecy, man? But I think he said something to her, that the Lord is going to use that to glorify God. I don't know, man, how they say that. So apparently she drives with border, and when she reaches the other guys, turns out these are vampires. They cut her body, and they start sucking her blood. Now, that's why I keep on telling you, stop watching the originals and Vampire Diaries. That's a movie. When you watch those things, you turn called Birota. It's the time I watched a series about, I watched this movie called Underworld. I had not paid rent, and then I dreamt that the landlord had sent a werewolf to ask for rent money, and it was chasing me, man. So stop watching vampire movies because of just Birota. So apparently, these other border guys were vampires. Then they cut her hands, then they start sucking blood. Now, first of all, they are not scared of sucking blood, you know. But did they first check you for STDs and HIV? Okay, that's stigmatizing to the HIV community. I'm sorry, I take that back. Let's look for another example. What if you have high blood pressure and you're drinking blood which has high blood pressure? Or some other disease? What if she has pneumonia? What if she has some blood infection? You can't drink somebody's blood. What if this person, imagine if you had to drink like MC Cat's blood, you are literally drinking whiskey. What if you drink like Nubian Lee's blood, you're literally getting high on weed. Before you drink somebody's blood, you have to know what do they put in your body. Imagine you drink like a blood of bad black. You would rather eat bleaching cream. Because injections in the bleaching. Imagine drinking like the blood of whom? Okay, I've run out of examples. But don't drink the one of my chorus, because, man, you'll be broke until you die. So they saw the blood of this girl. Then they started drinking it. And the girl was like, oh, my God. Then she said, I called on Jesus. I said, Jesus. Now, Jesus, I don't know what's up with his communication, but he takes long to answer. You know, that's how everyone who talks to Jesus says. You never call Jesus and he replies on the first time. Either he's too much of a celebrity, or he needs you to fast, like, you know, because he's like, Jesus! Jesus was like, I think Jesus was compensating. Like, Angel Gabriel, why they call me like this, man? Say, Jesus! Then he called him Jesus at that time. Then Jesus was like, hi, baby girl, I am here. Lord. So Jesus comes out, and then he meets her. And to the surprise of all of us who are listening to the stories, Jesus does not beat off the vampires. He lets them eat her blood. Then he pulls her out of the body. Then her and Jesus, because Jesus came with two angels. Jesus is a chameleon. He's a chameleon. Sure that he's powerful. But Jesus cannot step out alone. Man, someone has to open his door. So when Jesus came and parked his escalade, someone opened the door. Jesus got out and he had two angels. Angel Joseph over angel Moses. I don't know. Over angel Bamuguru. Then he called her out of the body. Then they both stood there and they were watching her body be eaten by border vampires. This story is dumb. I'm not like she said these things on YouTube. So she said that Jesus is beautiful and handsome, but he looked troubled. Hey, first go back. Jesus looked beautiful and handsome. Now that means that either this woman is lying or the Bible is lying to us. Because they said that all of us were created in God's image. How can Jesus be beautiful, and also Katolwama was created in the image of God? Katolwama looks like a dinosaur. So something is not adding up. They say we're created in the image of God. At least me. See, look at me. Women look at me and get sexually aroused because I'm attractive. Okay, that's a point of contention. But you know, like, you know, so a man like Medad Segona. That's how Jesus looks like. If Jesus comes to take us back to heaven and it looks like Medad Segona, we are not leaving. We are going to stay on Instagram. Sure, Lord. You might be taking us to hell. You might be the devil. Okay, that's a joke. I hope no one takes me serious. So, Jesus comes, and she said that when Jesus was looking a little bit puzzled, she realized that he looked like he was waiting. No, so Jesus, yeah, but dad, what? So, she's like, it seems Jesus is waiting for someone. And bah, 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 that someone arrived, and what was Elvis Imbonyama? Nadia, Obaya is a Range Rover. Then he came. And to her surprise, when she met Jesus, when Mbonye met Jesus, he was not bending down, worshipping. No. Mbonye met Jesus, he was like, I died. Jesus was like, I saw. Why don't you follow me back on Twitter? Okay, maybe I'm adding in some statements. But that's what she said. She said that Jesus and Mbonye were like friends. Not like this whole thing, I'm God. Because me, I would think that when you see Jesus, according to how they describe to us Jesus, they say that he glitters. You know, Jesus looks like too much lighting. So, but when you looked at him, Nagamba China, Nebebunga Kom, he was like, man, China, ye, man. Yes, Namgamba, man, but in Tambri, your man, we're getting money, maybe, yeah, so potos, man, what's up with him? But he was like, man, I'm hitting gym. Yeah, Jesus was like, by the way, I also changed that now, I'm vegetarian. So, after that, Jesus told him, Bonya, he's like, anyway, Bonya, I take your daughter. It's not yet her time to come to heaven. I want you to listen to think about everything that I just said. Someone said that, and people believe it. Maybe I might have added in some a little bit of unseriousness, because that I can't help. But that's the storyline of this lady. Prophetess, over prophetess, Babilie, Juliet. That's her storyline. People listen to this stuff and believe it. Yet for us, when we tell our girlfriends we are not cheating, they don't believe it. What is wrong with women? Okay, maybe I'm becoming personal. How do you believe this nonsense? Remnants, you're stupid. I have said it. Can't you tell me what could be? Remnants, you're stupid. Please, you can worship everything you want to worship, but temo babasiru, don't cross a particular line. Jesus, I don't have a problem with you going to Mbonye's church, but you should be able to disagree with some things in that church. About a person drinking blood? Let's go for a break. We shall come back. We have to fight about this. Let's go for a short break.